Hello, and welcome to our first part of our online physical geography course. I would like to take a couple moments to outline some of the content areas and really push us through just to see what we're going to be discovering within this portion of the module. So I've already pulled up my portion of Canvas, and I want to kind of go through some of the content with you. So as you can see, we have within part one, we've got our overview and our focus questions. We are covering four units, units 1 through 4, introduction to geography as a discipline, Earth's place within the cosmos, introduction to geology and geologic time, and mapping Earth's surface. We also have some online multimedia that's been added. It's not required, but I think it's quite helpful. There are things that I would show in my normal face-to-face class. We also have some assignments, as you can see. You've got your discussion, reading quiz, check-in, and also an extra credit activity. So real quick, as you can see, the books are PDF, the chapters themselves. We have four chapters we'll be going through. For Unit 1, which is Introduction to Geography as a Discipline, to really kind of summarize what that is essentially geography is a really multifaceted topic. I think most people assume that geography, you know, because I have a degree in geography, that I'm good at giving directions or reading maps, and I might be some of those things, but that's not really what geography is in its entirety. It's really, really broad, because geography is really the place, location, it's data, I always felt it was the word why. Why? Why are mountains here? Why are volcanoes there? Why does music come from certain locations and regions of the world? What about languages? What about food and spices and architecture? And so it becomes really a large topic. That's what always excited me. I was a music major to begin with, and then when I realized that there's more geography with music than just music alone, like as an example, when you study at the Motown sound, the beach sound, you know, when you think about different regions in California, the Bay Area was known for Green Day, going down into San Diego would have been known for musicians like Sublime and things like that. You know, what does the geography do or change or contribute to music? What does it do with the landscapes? What about climate? You know, the weather is very different. If you're going to go to the beach in California, but you don't specify if you're going to be up in San Francisco or San Diego, you're going to be wearing very different clothing, even during the summer itself. So it's really a big picture thing, and it's really, really kind of, it's an exciting thing. Make sure there's map quizzes and stuff like that, but the reality is it's a lot bigger than that. It's very exciting. That being said, moving forward, Earth's place within the cosmos is that we are a planet, and there are other planets within our solar system, then moving into our universe, and then to infinity and beyond. That being said, understanding our place, well, how did Earth come to be? Where did the moon come from? The moon was part of the Earth, and there was an impact, and so there's all these different attributes that help then realize our location or realization within our solar system. Who knows? At one point, we could, you know, become inhabitants of other planets. You know, things that we talk about in my other face-to-face classes, like Pluto. Is Pluto a planet or is it not? It has landforms. We can't get to it. It's too cold. It's made out of slush. And there's so many different discussion pieces to that. So then moving forward, since we're talking about rock, we introduce geologic time and geology. And, you know, geology is really the fine details. You know, geography looks at the landscape, geology looks at the rock and go, well, what is this rock made out of? How old is this rock? What minerals and what atoms and what, you know, when you look at the periodic table of elements, when those are mushed together, what type of minerals can we make and what type of rocks can become of that? We'll talk about absolute and relative dating. Absolute is using a chemically done situation and say this rock is exactly this old, versus relative dating, which is like the laws of stratigraphy, which means that if things are placed on top of each other, the one below should be the oldest that would have been put there first. That being said, moving forward, we look into mapping the Earth's surface, not just with topographic maps, but looking at a grid system and looking at other ways that we can pinpoint a location. You use these type of things all the time. You just don't realize it. When you log on to your cell phone and you say, oh, I'm checking in on Facebook at this restaurant, it's utilizing a GPS coordinate of your cell phone and trying to pinpoint where you are. You're using the grid system. The main one that we'll talk about for this course is latitude and longitude. Latitude, like a ladder, goes up and down. It goes from here, 90 degrees north to the North Pole, 90 degrees south to the South Pole. When I think of latitude, I think of pizza, because it's these big, large pans. We're talking about the distance all the way around. So the greatest pizza is going to be the equator. Like a protractor from the center up, The highest I can go is 90, so maybe I'm going up to 22.5 degrees. Then I draw my circle going all the way around. Well, what we begin to notice is that latitude, based off the equator, 0, 90 north, 90 south, is that these disks become smaller as we get closer to the poles. If you've ever flown internationally, you would know that. You know, if you're leaving from maybe LAX and going into Paris, you're not going to go in a straight line. You're actually going to curve, because by curving and going higher up in latitude, the distance around the Earth becomes smaller, so you actually travel faster versus going straight across in a straight line, which is pretty unique. If you've ever done that, you've probably seen the headrest, and you'd be like, oh, that's kind of weird. We do a curve versus just going straight across. Longitude is the other part of that, so we have kind of our XY coordinate system where we pinpoint a location. When we look at longitude, that's again measured from the center of the Earth, going a maximum of 180 behind, so 180 west, 180 east, that creates a complete circle, 360. Longitude itself, again, 0 to 180. Once we measure the angle like a protractor, then we draw going up and down. Lines of longitude are called meridians because they're half of great circles. They intersect at the north and the south pole. So they're kind of like an orange. You peel it away and you have a crescent or a half circle. So we have that. So between lines like this and then lines like this, we can create an intersecting point. Another thing to mention, going back to latitude. Latitude, those lines, I compare them to pizza pans or disks that wrap around the Earth. They're also parallel. They'll never intersect. Longitude, though, does intersect, so you kind of create that grid system. As you work through this week, as I said, you've got discussions, you've got reading quizzes, and also extra credit activities. Discussions require an initial post, and then you follow up with at least two responses. If you continue with maybe three or four, you'll earn extra points, which is great, because everyone doesn't love extra credit. Yeah, you also have reading quizzes. You get two attempts. Please complete both, because you will probably get a different set of questions, and that's great, because that will give you more questions in your little bank that you can use for the midterm, because a lot of those questions will be repeated. Also, Canvas takes the higher out of the two, so it's really not a waste to do. So please take both attempts. Then lastly, you'll see these extra credit assignments that keep popping up. It's an activity, you complete it, you take a screenshot of it, and you need a score of at least 80% or more, then you submit that to Canvas with your little game that you played, and then you earn some bonus points there as well. That being said, since we're mentioning points, just be aware, again, that I do not accept late work. This is such a fast-paced course, I don't have time, and you don't have time to kind of go back. So don't go back. Go forward. Please work forward. Many of you have already started working forward. That's great. I've already unlocked most of the class, so you can go ahead and start working ahead. The advantage of working ahead is, one, you don't fall behind, and two, is if there's any questions or things that you need help with, that gives us time to give you that feedback so you can get the better score. That being said, welcome to part one, and we'll see you soon.